You guys have done a piss poor job of convincing me that I should vote for a Democrat.
Whoopi, I agree with Whoopi. We'll be right back. I got a headache. And joining us, Fox News contributor Lisa Boothe, 2020 senior advisor Mercedes Schlapp.
Have a headache now.
It's like that every day.
Yeah, of course it is. But in Megan's defense, I mean, has the Democrat Party given anyone a reason to vote for Democrats right now? And if you're looking specifically at Mike Bloomberg, I mean, what's his message? What is he running on?
Broad sweeping generalizations about minorities and farmers need more gray matter, and it's easy to be a farmer. I can teach you to be a farmer in seconds.
But so here's the challenge for Democrats right now. I mean, you see them desperately scrambling for a Bernie Sanders alternative because Bernie Sanders is the only one who's been consistently polling at the top.
Right?
You've seen these flavors of the week. So you've got, it was Pete Buttigieg, and then it was Amy Klobuchar during New Hampshire. Now it's Mike Bloomberg, and he's the only candidate. He's completely untested. He's not even competed yet. He's not been on a debate stage. He hasn't won a single delegate. And he's been hiding behind this manufactured version of himself, hundreds of millions of dollars in paid advertising, making him look good. They can make anyone look good. And now he's actually going to have to be unfiltered version, real version, boring Bloomberg, who's made these past statements that he's going to have to own up to.
Okay, I mean, the broad sweeping generalizations on minorities. Okay, big part of the Democratic base, Mercedes. And the issues with women. Oh, just kill it. I don't think that's going to go over particularly well. They're going after gays, lesbians, and transgenders. We find out from the Daily News tonight, assuming they're correct. And yes, farmers need more gray matter. It's easy. I could teach you to be a farmer in 5 seconds. Just put a seed in the ground and cover it and water it.
Well, I think what you're seeing in The View is what you're seeing in the Democrat Party, which is just pure chaos and stress because they have what options? A self-proclaimed socialist versus this cruel, racist,
elitist
former mayor
snob
of New York City who has obviously all of these things that are coming out is showing his true colors, that of being biased against minorities, against transgenders. And then, I think that you're seeing the fact that there is so much stress accumulated in that party because they're looking at their options saying Donald Trump's going to beat all of them.
I have an idea. Who would like to see, Lisa, I'd like to see Mayor Mike in overalls and go out and farm for a few days.
Well, I don't think he would, which is part of the challenge, right? I mean, look, listen to Mike Bloomberg for 5 minutes. I implore everyone at home, go and listen
about
to him
mother.
For
Mother's
five
playing
minutes.
Scrabble with the
doesn't,
housekeeper.
Doesn't matter which the clip. Just look at him for 5 minutes and then ask yourself, is this the guy who's going to turn out anyone to vote? Is this the guy that's going to get anyone excited to go turn out and vote?
No.
Especially when you look at someone like President Trump, who's an incumbent. He's running on a strong economy.
Yeah,
also, mind you,
the last 30
let's
seconds.
Remember.
Well, let me get this.
Yeah.
So Mercedes, will the base of the party that he keeps insulting go vote for him and go fight for him? I don't think so.
No, absolutely not. I think what you're finding is the fact that even members of their own party, like Elizabeth Warren calling him an egomaniac billionaire, I mean, they're on the attack to take Bloomberg down. And that's why tomorrow's debate is going to be critical to see if Bloomberg can be left standing in any way.
Yeah, I can't wait to watch Farmer Mike. All right. Thank you both. When we come back.